Back in my first year, when I first entered UBC, I was still used to the workflows and the habits of how I learned in high school.
When I first started, I was definitely quite naive about the work that was needed to put into it to be successful.
Since I'd found that in high school I could get by with minimal studying, and after midterm one, I discovered that that was not the case.
Because the mark I had gotten was way lower than what I had hoped for and expected.
I did so badly on that midterm. I felt so demoralized.
I remember feeling quite overwhelmed and occasionally doubted whether I'd be able to keep up with university-level academics.
This was a huge wake-up call that something I was doing wasn't working.
And that it's really up to you to adapt and learn what does work in university.
So I realized that I needed to be taking a much more active role in my own learning.
Knowing that you're struggling is the best thing you can go through, because they can think, what's what I'm doing that I could potentially change? So going forward, I can improve and attain the success that I'm looking for.
In university, like, you have to adapt your study strategies. It doesn't always fly what you did in high school.
Some of the major realizations that I made about studying were that it's better to work smarter as opposed to harder.
I needed to be more clear in delineating what I did know and what I did not know. And I needed to be much more proactive in addressing what I did not know.
There are many factors that come into play, and the reality is that each activity requires different strategies. So three main questions are, where am I going? So what's your goal? How am I getting there? How am I doing? And what else can I do? What's next for me?
So my secret sauce change was really realizing that I didn't have to struggle on my own.
My favorite study techniques would definitely be explaining things that I studied out loud.
So making up questions for myself, talking to myself.
If you can teach it to someone else, it's likely that you really know it yourself.
And you will learn as you challenge yourself to find out, if I want to be an expert in this field, what's what I have to do?
I would definitely make sure to follow the learning objectives as a guide that the professor sets out for you.
For quizzes, for midterms, for exams, for assignments, you name it, it's in there, most likely.
And if there's a piece that you don't understand as a student, that's when you seek help.
So there's science peer academic coaches, of course, and there's also your professor and TAs at office hours and learning centers.
Bringing in these specific concepts that you're struggling with really helps.
And there's, of course, your classmates. So study groups can be a great way to stay motivated and keep practicing course material.
The big question is, what does it mean to study? Is studying reading? Is studying writing? Or does it involve a process in which I go to class with a purpose of learning because I want to learn, not because I want to get a good grade? It's because I'm interested, highly motivated to learn about this topic.
Last but arguably most importantly, always prioritize things like sleep and breaks, because by prioritizing your mental and physical health,
help me to engage as a student better in the subject matter.
Because in first year especially, you're just here to learn how to study, and part of that is making mistakes, trying new things that, you know, some might work out, some you might discard. Just be patient and don't beat yourself up about it.
So it's a lot of knowledge about yourself that comes in when you want to study in a meaningful way. That's what learning at university is about, right? It's just being in control of your learning.